And I'm back with more Phoenix Wright Ace Attorney Trials and Tribulations. And we're about to hit a doozy of a tribulation as Dahlia Hawthorne, aka Melissa Foster, has taken the stand. And yeah, we're fucked. Indeed. Thank you, Mr. Edgeworth. You are a true gentleman. Miss Faye, you could learn a lot from this man. If he's such a gentleman, he sure doesn't act like it to me.
Sir?
Hmm? Yes, what is it?
This is my first time, so I'm sure I'll make a lot of mistakes. Anyway, I just wanted to say I'm sorry for all the trouble I might cause.
No, it's
no trouble at all. Now then, may we please have your name and occupation? My name is Melissa Foster. I am a college student, a freshman in the literature department.
You were at the scene of the unfortunate event occurred, correct? And you were the one who took this photo?
Is that accurate? How could you be so mean?
See, what are you doing shoving it in her face like that?
I was asking a question. It's just a photo. It's not something dangerous.
Next time I'll be forced to penalize you.
I don't like how this turn is taken. What the? Is she staring at me? You would be...
What? I'm the defense attorney. My name is Mia Faye.
I see. So you are...
Now then, young lady, could you give us an explanation and a testimony?
Yes, Your Honor. I'll do my best.
Oh. God damn it.
I was using my camera to take pictures of wildflowers. And then I noticed there were two people standing up on the suspension bridge. Suddenly, they started fighting. That's when I hurried and took the photo and showed the critical moment. And after that, I called the police.
By the way, where were you standing when the incident occurred? I believe the map would be helpful.
I was standing right over here. I was in a beautiful field surrounded by cliffs.
So you took your photo from that location?
I brought the camera with me that I was using, just like Mr. Edgeworth told me to.
Oh, what a cute camera, just like its owner. All right then, Miss Faye, time for your cross-examination. But I warn you, make the witness cry again and you'll feel the wrath of my gavel. Look, I know about what she can do, right?
She's a conniving bitch, and I'm gonna prove it.
Alright, fourth statement. It's 2, 3, 4.
Fourth or fifth statement. Let's keep...
Witness. When you said you took a photo of the crucial moment, is that what you meant? All I can see in this photo are two people facing each other. You testified that you saw them when they started to fight. Normally, that's the kind of thing we would refer to as a crucial moment. Why haven't you presented a photo like that?
Well, you see...
The photo we presented was the only one there was. But if you really wanted to capture the crucial moment, then what happened next? You must have gotten a photo of it. My apologies, young man. But Miss Faye's assertion is not without a certain amount of merit. He can certainly downplay a situation, can't he?
I'm sorry. I'm a very bad girl. I used it all up, the film...
You ran out of film?
This photo was the last one.
What?
Unfortunately, that is the truth. I personally examined all the photos she took that day. All of the other photos were of the witness herself playing amongst the flowers. The witness herself? Then who took all the photos? Well, my camera has a timer feature built in. So you took the photos of yourself? I remember taking some photos of myself once too. Please, no details. We don't need to see how you grew your playoff beard. It seems that Miss Faye's assertion was not so decisive after all. Just a minute. Well, if she had no film left, she couldn't very well take more pictures. Miss Foster, perhaps you could tell us a different thing, a different sort of photo. Photos of the incident you took with your very eyes. Mr. Edgeworth, you're quite the poet. Oh, they're birds of a feather, I can guarantee you. Very well, let's get back to the cross-examination. Let's hear your thoughts on the fight that you witnessed.
Yes, Mr. Judge.
Boy, this guy's really a sucker for sweet talk. Looks like the other kitten in the room is the one getting all the attention. It's sickening. I screwed up. Damn it. Damn it. Ah, man. Okay. Okay, so they kind of screwed me up. Alright. I hate when they do that. Okay, so revised fourth statement. Fifth statement. Dusky Bridge. Okay. Oh, that's what happened. They reset me. Sometimes the game will reset you back on the first statement, or they'll put you back in the statement that you were just in. So it doesn't stay consistent when it does that. So say you are following a guide and then you're on the same thing, you're just like, well, nope. 2, 4. There we go. Your testimony's a joke.
What? But I just...
Miss Faye, I thought I warned you not to make the witness cry. One short testimony and two bad contradictions. There's no possible excuse. You say there were two? It's simple. Just take a look at the diagram of the area. According to her testimony, the two of them were in the middle of the bridge. But if they were, and the victim had turned around, well, she would have hit a dead end. You said 10 yards, but it couldn't even have been 5, because Dusky Bridge was collapsed on that side. What does that mean? It's very simple. This charming little witness is telling a charming little lie. That's all there is to it. This beautiful young lady's been lying to the court? Just a moment. Miss Ridgeworth. Your Honor, allow me to personally apologize for the confusion.
What do you mean?
There's one major mistake in this diagram. What are you referring to? It's all because of the diagram was made after the incident occurred. It's a very old bridge, and we couldn't find any official blueprints. I'm saying that even though the bridge is currently in disrepair...
Oh.
There's no evidence that can prove that the bridge was broken during the incident. It's ridiculous! You can't actually tell the condition of the bridge from this photo. I apologize for not being more clear. Even I don't buy this. That guy's good. What? What do you mean? He planned it from the beginning. He is a genius, all right. The diagram of the bridge was his insurance policy. What? A coward! Well, it seems you've made yet another reckless accusation.
I'm so sorry. I should have been more careful.
No, no, no. It wasn't your fault at all. Shall we go on with the trial? I would like to establish once and for all that it was what our witness actually saw. Indeed. All right, young lady, may I ask you to please proceed with your testimony?
But it's so hard.
We're all on your side, Miss Foster. There's no need to worry. Just tell us what you saw.
Yes, sir. After he stabbed her in the back, he quickly picked her up in her arms. Then he carried her over to the car. I suppose that's the only way he could have made sure the body stayed hidden.
Well, dumping it into the river would have made sense.
He couldn't just leave the body on top of the bridge. I'm sorry, I'm only supposed to talk about what I saw.
Witnessing such violence must have been difficult.
Yes, sir, I'm still a little shaken up.
If he accepts his testimony as it is, we're finished. Don't say that. Oh, well, maybe I'll stop at my favorite cafe on the way home. They make a great mocha latte. His trial's not over yet. That's what I like to hear. Miss Faye, your cross-examination, if you please. Contradiction staring you right in the face. Go on the attack. Well, my first attack's gonna be pretty obvious. Third statement. Dusky Bridge.
Yay! I know what I'm doing!
Okay, one, two... A killer not wanting his victim to be found, I can understand. However, the idea of moving the body for that purpose is clearly odd. There was a much easier way to make the body not found. Well, take another look at the map of the area and you'll see how. There's a river right below the bridge. Earlier, Mr. Edgeworth pointed out something interesting about the river. For those who are unaware, Eagle River is well known for its powerful current. Most bodies that fall into the river are never recovered. In this kidnapping case 5 years ago, the victim's body was carried away and never found. If 10 murders were to occur in the same spot, you can bet your boots that every other killer would have tossed the body into the water!
Order!
I'm not sure if I care for the way you put it, Miss Faye, because these boots are made for walking. But I must admit, that does seem odd not to have the body thrown in the river. Oh, she's getting flustered now. Mr. Edgeworth. How sad. Perhaps Miss Faye would try taking a dip in the river herself. After all, you claim to be such an expert in the ways of nature. What are you talking about? My point is, no matter how odd you may find the killer's methods, the fact is, that's what the killer did. None of your arguments have anything to do with the witness. Quite true. Miss Faye, it seems your assertion is without merit after all. But what the witness claims is totally ridiculous. Surely you can't deny that the body was found in the trunk of the car. Certainly consistent with what the witness has been saying. Please, go on with your testimony.
Okay, I'll try.
All you have to do is tell us what you saw. Otherwise, that mean lady might yell at you again.
Who's he talking about? All right, I'll do my best.
Okay, revised third statement. Dusky Bridge...
See, they did it again.
Well, Miss Foster, it looks like you've done it this time. Done what?
Made a crucial mistake. Like what, Miss Faye?
The killer broke into the trunk of the stolen car and hid the body? Are you saying that's what you saw, with your very own eyes?
Yes, and?
It's simple. Take a look at this diagram. The place you claim to have taken the photo from is here. Do you see what I mean? Even if you tried to see the car, this outcropping of rock is directly in your way.
That's right. From where you were standing, you could not have possibly seen the killer's car.
Objection.
I admit the diagram shows a large outcropping of rock. It isn't so tall that it would stop her from seeing it.
That's right. It's not that high at all. I was able to see his car just fine.
I'm so sorry, but that just doesn't wash. I believe it was the witness who presented this as evidence in the court, yes? This is the location the photo was taken from. Your own photo tells the whole story. You can clearly see the left side of the bridge, but the outcropping that's being referred to is more likely a cliff.
Uh-huh.
Your view should have been completely cut off by the cliff, but still you claim that you've been able to see the killer's car.
No!
She's so screwed. What is the meaning of all this ballyhoo? Your Honor, don't jump to any hasty conclusion. The fact that the escapee fled in a stolen car was reported on the news. After witnessing a murder, I'm sure you can appreciate the witness was very upset. She must have heard about the stolen car and convinced herself that she saw it. But she was repeatedly warned before starting her testimony. She was told to testify only about what she saw with her own eyes.
I think I must have remembered something wrong.
Hey, wait a minute! You can't just say that. Miss Faye, no one on the face of this planet is perfect. Quite true, as they say. To err is human, to forgive, divide. I'm inclined to give the benefit of the doubt to the witness.
What? It's not fair!
Ugh. Save the tears for later. Mr. Armando, don't look back until the trial's over. Now is the time to go forward.
This is not fair!
Okay, you need to relax. Then you need to remember the other kitten's testimony. So tell me, how'd she know that? How did she know that he broke into the trunk? Well, until you can explain how you knew that, you're going to give a lot of very suspicious people on this side of the courtroom.
Well, witness, I'm certain he broke into the trunk, because there were marks left on the trunk lid. I'm certain there were scratch marks when he broke into it.
What? Let me see that. It's true, there certainly are scratch marks on the keyhole. It's quite obvious this trunk has been broken open. Well, Miss Faye, are you satisfied?
The judge is on her side, I can't make any mistakes. What she just said. Is there a contradiction somewhere?
Melissa Foster, looks like you finally betrayed yourself.
What?
You said that you were taking photos in a field full of flowers. But even so, you knew about the scratches. The question is when? When did you get to see those scratches?
Finally, I've got her.
I'm getting pretty tired of waiting here. Then perhaps you would be faster if Miss Faye explained herself. Your Honor, there's only one possible explanation. The reason the witness had seen the scratches... There's only one way the witness had the chance to see those scratches.
What is it?
Naturally, when she opened the trunk and stuffed the corpse in herself. The person who really hid the body in the trunk of the car was Melissa Foster! It was you who did it, wasn't it?
This is ridiculous! I could never! It was the man in the prison garb! He's the one that...
I don't think so. Mr. Falls had been the one to put the corpse in the trunk. He would have simply used the car key. There would have been no need to break it open. But he stole a car! He stole it from a young couple that had been waiting at a red light, which means that the key would have still been in the ignition. I see. Thank you for telling us about the scratches, Miss Foster. Without that, we would have never uncovered the truth. That it could have not been Mr. Falls that put the body in the trunk. Stupid phone. Preposterous! To even suggest the witness put the body in there. If that were true, then how would you explain the photo she took? The corpse could only have been put in the trunk when the incident occurred. And we already know that at the time she was taking photographs. Now's your chance, Mia. Finish this thing. On the contrary, I'm not so sure anymore. There's no need to think that deeply about it. What I'm saying is the shutter for this may have been pushed by Miss Foster herself. Let's take another look at this camera and see its features on it, shall we? There's a timer built in, even a mini tripod. Why, it's almost as if she brought the camera just to take this picture. What are you trying to say then? That when the crime occurred, Miss Foster wasn't in the field as she claimed? Well, if she really did use the camera's auto timer, then the answer is yes, she was somewhere else. She was not in the field. Would the defense please explain further? This is a crucial point. Where was Miss Foster when the incident occurred? And answering that question will also make clear her true identity. Well, then, please answer the question. Where was Melissa Foster when the incident on the bridge occurred? Naturally, the witness was right here. Blech, that's where the victim, Miss Hawthorne, was standing. Order! Miss Faye, what on earth? Your Honor, if I may. After parting with the victim on the bridge, the defendant fled by car. But this would mean that there was no time to put the victim in the trunk. In other words, if someone put the body in the trunk, it could have only been before the defendant had met the victim. How asinine. Of course Mr. Falls met with the victim. The only person who had the opportunity to put the victim in the trunk is the same man that killed her, Terry Falls. You still don't understand, do you? By the time the witness's photo was taken, the victim was already dead. The person in that photo is not Valerie Hawthorne. What? I've never heard anything more ridiculous in my life. Then who exactly is the victim in the photo? It's obvious. It's your own witness. What? It's the only possible explanation. The woman that Mr. Falls met on the bridge was not Valerie Hawthorne. It was you, Melissa Foster. Me? Let's remember that it was raining and foggy on the mountain that day. Mr. Falls himself believed that the woman in front of him was Valerie Hawthorne. But the defendant knew that Valerie Hawthorne very well. After all, she was the woman whose testimony helped get him convicted. But since then, my client has spent 5 hard years in the federal penitentiary. He couldn't remember exactly what she looked like anymore. You're just making this up. Where's your proof? I've got it right here. This will blow the case wide open. At the time of the incident, he'd forgotten what Valerie Hawthorne looked like. Mr. Falls had forgotten the victim's face. That's why he needed some sort of identification, namely this muddy scarf. It was Mr. Falls who requested that we wear this scarf to identify herself. It had already been proven by the note the victim left. In other words, as long as you were wearing a scarf that, like he'd asked, anyone could have pretended to be Valerie Hawthorne. Well, what do you have to say to that, Melissa Foster? Oh. Uh-oh. Well, now it's getting interesting. Where's Miss Foster? She's collecting herself in the lobby. It's obvious she did it. She hid the body in the trunk and disguised herself as the victim. She set up the camera to snap a fake photo of them together. The only question is why. Well, isn't it obvious? She's the real culprit. We'll have to wait for Miss Foster to compose herself before we start again. Until then, this court is in recess. The defense and prosecution are both to wait in their respective lobbies. Yes, Your Honor. Understood. Very well, this court is in recess. Hooray! Things are getting interesting. I love it! Make sure to save, and make sure I have the episode in question. Always a good idea.